Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurve Namaha. Dhyan Moolam Gurur Murti, Puja Moolam Gurur Padam, Mantra Moolam Gurur Vakyam, Moksha Moolam Guru Kripa. Brahmanandam Paramasukhadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvanvatitam Gaganasadrisham Tattvamasyadi Lakshyam. If I literally explain the word Ram, then it means the one who is existing everywhere. When I say everywhere, then it means at molecular level to cellular level, Lord is everywhere. From Vedanta's perspective, when we say Lord or God, then it simply means this. The existence which is truth, the existence which is bliss, the existence which is super consciousness, and the existence which is all pervasive, omniscient. So the Sanskrit word is sat, chit, anand, vyapak. No matter what religion you believe in, you cannot say that your God is not truth. You cannot say your God is not conscious. Can you? You can say your God is not blissful. Your God is not present everywhere. Well, in the monotheistic religion, all religion, I'm saying the monotheistic religion, they say God is one, and God is the only one, but lives somewhere far away from us. Hence the idea of keeping the God on a big throne, and the God is always he, never she. I don't know why. God is always a he and never a she. And it's always a father figure. And, maybe all the books have been written by men, and most of the messiahs and prophets had been men, hence God also had to be a man. So you know. But when we say God, then the Vedantic concept says God is neither he nor a she. So the right word which has been used is just one, and that is Sat. Sat means the truth. Paramatma purush hai ki aurat hai. Dekhi, aap log jab bhi prarthana karte ho, to ye bolo na Bhagwan kripa kar dega, ye nahi kehte degi. Bhagwan hamari sunta nahi, ye nahi kehte Bhagwan meri sunti nahi. So, ज्यादा करके धर्मों में प्रार्थनाएं जब की जाती हैं तब ईश्वर को पुरुष मान करके की जाती है. वो मुक्ति देगा, वो दान देगा, वो कृपा देगा, वो आनंद देगा, वो मोक्ष देगा, देगा, देगी नहीं. पर गीता कहती है, उपनिषद कहते हैं, बाबा नानक की वाणी कहती है, ना वो स्त्री है, ना वो पुरुष है, वो ओंकार स्वरूप है. और सत्य है, चैतन्य है, आनंद है और व्यापक है. The physical boundaries divide us. Because with the physicality comes the colors. So a Caucasian has a white, and an Asian would have a brown, and an African might have a very black color tone. So the moment you bring bodies, then the colors come, races come, shapes come, forms come, so many differences come. But if I say, look in your mind, is your mind fair or black or brown? What is the color of mind? This is my question to all of you. Don't just sit beautiful. Have some conversation with me. And I give you this question. Is your mind having any color, a black or a brown or a red or a yellow? Huh? Man ka kya rang hai? Kala hai, gora hai, neela hai, bhura hai, man kaisa hai? Achha, ye batao, man purush hai ki man istri hai? If I bring the sex in, then is your mind a male or a female? Can you say mind is male or a female? No. Even if you could have a conversation with a dog or a cat and ask the dog or a cat or any animal, what is the gender of your mind? And if they could speak to us and if we could talk back with them and understand what they are saying, even they would say, mind is neither male nor female. So if we peel the layer of the body and peel the layer of mind, and the third layer is if we peel the layer of the intellect, which everybody I hope have. Now your intellect, is it male or female? अच्छा हिंदी भाषा में बड़ा मस्त है हिंदी भाषा में मेरी बुद्धि काम नहीं करती और फिर कभी बोलेंगे मेरा दिमाग काम नहीं करता तो ती भी है और ता भी है पर हम बुद्धि को क्या कहेंगे दिमाग को क्या कहेंगे कि हमारी जो अक्ल है ये मेल है या फीमेल ना मेल है ना फीमेल ना स्त्रीलिंग है ना पुरुष लिंग है ये सो लेट मी पुट इट लाइक दिस What you see yourself as a body, you are just not a body. You have one more thing inside this body and that is your mind. Right? Am I right? Are you with me? We have a body and we have a mind. Now, do we have a mind alone or do we have, apart from the mind, one another entity and that is your intellect? Right? So you have a body, you have a mind, and you have intellect. And you know what? The fourth thing is you. So I'm saying you have an intellect, you have a mind, and you have a body. This means you are not the body, you are not the mind, you are not the intellect. You are neither of these three. कि हमारा शरीर है जिसको हम देखते हैं इस शरीर के अंदर फिर एक मन है और इस मन के पीछे एक और है जिसे हम कहते हैं बुद्धि ये शरीर भी मैं नहीं हूं ये बुद्धि भी मैं नहीं हूं और बीच में जो दूसरा है ये मन भी मैं नहीं हूं तो शरीर मन बुद्धि से अलग मैं आत्मस्वरूप हूं और ये ही आत्मा परमात्मा स्वरूप है See, that's the beauty. You're not the body, you're not the mind, you're not the intellect. So if we remove these three layers, then beneath these three layers is you, the real you. And this real you is called the pure self. And this very pure self, Vedanta says, is God. Like every drop of water has ocean in it and every wave has water in it. So a wave, a water drop or a bigger drop or a bubble on the water is a water. So shapes are different, forms are different, but the water is same. Similarly, all of us who are sitting in this beautiful hall, we all have different faces, right? We all have different minds, right? What your mind knows, your neighbor doesn't know. What pain your mind knows, your neighbors who is sitting right now, even sometimes, the pain what a husband is feeling, wife doesn't know. What pain a wife is feeling, the husband doesn't know. What pain a father is feeling, the son or daughter doesn't know. What pain a daughter is feeling, sometimes the father doesn't know or the mother doesn't know. So you might share a one home address, but yet you don't share the minds. We are so aloof, and you know what? You go anywhere, what? Even if I go out, you will all bring out your phones and you will talk to phone, through the phone, through WhatsApp and Facebook and Instagram and whatever, to people who are not present here. And you will not be talking to the neighbor who is sitting right on the chair in front of you or at the back of you or by your side. We have lost the contact with person to person, and we are so busy in this make-believe fictional world of internet that we have lost our own connect with our own self, with our own mind, with our own heart. And you know, Uzdin, I was in airport and I saw this woman. She ordered coffee and a croissant, and she pulled out her phone and she clicked a photo. Not of herself, but of coffee, of the croissant, and then she uploaded it. And then maybe she WhatsApped it. And then she did my God knows what. So she was pretty busy. And I really felt like going to her and saying, excuse me, it seems you are not interested to eat. Can I take this? I'll save some euros. Because you are busy in your phone. And sometimes I'm seeing husband and wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, sitting, and they're all holding their phones. And I saw a family of six, big familia, all six people, phone. Phone se shaadi kar li hai inhone. Phone hi bachche ho gaya, phone ke nakli friends dost ho gaye hain, asli dost jinda ki mar gaye, pata nahi, wo bhi Facebook se pata chalta, achha, tu mar gaya. Aur phone mein hi likh dete hain, condolences. It's very strange. Somebody dies, you get information from Facebook, and then people are giving their condolences on the Facebook, and the person is gone, and they're saying, we are so sorry to know of your loss. And that person might be busy cremating the father. How would he read your message? But, you know, it's a horrible thing, but this is what happened. In India, actually, a person's dead body was lying, and there was this one neighbor who took a selfie with the cops and his hashtag with the dead body. So people are becoming insensitive. So much so that we are not ready to deal with living or a dead person, and we are so busy in getting some more followers or likes, you know, likes, that we have forgotten how to like our own life. We are not loving our life, we are not liking our life, we are just looking into that make-believe false social media. American Association of Psychiatry has already pronounced taking selfie as a disease. And they say, if you find somebody in your family taking selfies whole day, please bring them to a psychiatrist. The person needs some treatment. You know, gone nuts. Iska to dimag kharab ho gaya, dimag ghumela uska. बैठा सारा टाइम फोटो खींच रहा है बैठा सारा टाइम फोटो खींच रहा है तो हम जिस शरीर के साथ इतनी मोहब्बत कर रहे हैं भगवत गीता ये कहती है ये शरीर तुम हो ही नहीं, ये शरीर तुम्हारा है ही नहीं। गुरबाणी में एक पंक्ति आती, किथे तेंदे मापिया जिनी तें जने ओए, वे पासे ओ लद गए तू अजे ना पति ने ओए। दिस गुरु नानक्स वर्स इज सेइंग दैट वेयर आर योर फोर फादर्स, दे डाइड एंड देयर इज नो ट्रेस ऑफ देम लेफ्ट, those who gave you birth are now no more alive on the earth, and so is going to be your condition. In what fool's paradise are you living? This body is not me, this mind is not me, this intellect is not me, I am the pure self. And this very pure self is the divine, God, blissful embodiment. But if you don't look onto yourself, how will you know who you are? Because you are so busy looking on your body, looking on your mind, not that much, but it is all the time body, 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 what to eat. You know, I just had my dinner before coming here. And actually the food, I usually eat a khichdi, you know, it's a rice and lentil mixed, cooked together. And the lady kept khichdi, my staple diet, in front of me. And I'm just about to look into that. And she says, what will you eat tomorrow in the lunch? I said, hold it. I have yet not tasted the food now. How can I talk about the food what I will have tomorrow?